So today I'll be discussing unit 5 of the course on electronic circuits. This unit deals with the feedback amplifier. Although I have discussed about the feedback amplifier implicitly in unit 3 or unit 4, while we have considered the single stage amplifier or multi-stage amplifier, but at that time I have also told you that until and unless you understand what is the notion of feedback, you really don't appreciate whether the feedback is really present in any small signal amplifier or not. So this particular unit deals explicitly with feedback amplifier, and you have to identify whether any feedback is present within an amplifier or not, and if yes, then what type of feedback is present. So you have to identify the type of the feedback and the different attributes pertaining to this feedback amplifier. So to start with, let me just discuss about the notion of any feedback amplifier, the generic notion of feedback amplifier, and then obviously we will be discussing about the BJT realization. So notionally, this feedback can be regarded as a combination of two words. So what you are seeing on the screen is not a mirror image. I have intentionally written the back in this way to make sense that the back network receives a different types of signal as compared to the feed network. So let me just mark these two blocks separately, feed and back. Now, as far as our notation is concerned, whenever we consider any system, any arbitrary system, the input is applied at the left hand side of the box and the output is obtained from the right hand side. For example, if I have a system like this, any system is like this. So conventionally, we apply the input over here, that is X, and suppose the output resulting from the system is given by Y. So this is the convention. Now we are following the same convention over here. Now here, the feed network will receive the signal from this end. This is applied to the feed network, and accordingly, the feed network will generate some output over here. Now I have intentionally written the back word in this way to make sense that back network will receive the signal from this particular point. That means it will consider the output of the feed network as its input. And this is supplied over here at the input of the back network. And a portion of the output signal that is available over here, a portion of the output signal will be once again mixed at the input node over here. So the back network will generate some feedback signal or some signal over here, and this will be mixed at this particular point. So this is a mixer unit, mixer block. This is a mixer block. So eventually, this input, if I write, if the signal is represented by SS, and if this signal is represented by SO, so I understand that SS is the externally applied signal to this entire feedback network, and SO being the output of the feed network. Now, a portion of this output signal is fed to the back network, and a corresponding signal is generated over here, which I represent by SF. Now, this SS and SF, they are added by means of this mixer block, and the signal will be developed over here, which I write like SI. Now, depending upon the phase between this SS and SF, there can be two different types of feedback. So if I write that the signal SI is represented as SS plus SF, then this type of feedback is known as a positive feedback. This is known as a positive feedback because the feedback signal SF adds on in same phase with SS. On the other hand, if I write SI as SS minus SF, then this is known to be a kind of negative feedback. So in this case, the phase of the signal SS and that of SF are just the opposite. So if I want to represent it by means of some waveform, so for example, if SS looks something like that, a sinusoidal one like this, then whenever during the positive cycle, suppose this is SS, and suppose this is SF. So what happens during the positive cycle, positive half cycle, when SS is positive, during that time, this SF is negative. Although there is a magnitude difference, so we must understand that the magnitude of SS and the magnitude of SF are not the same. But whenever there is a positive excursion for SS, so you'll find that there will be a negative excursion for SF. So as a matter of fact, this feedback signal will make the signal SI less as compared to the signal SS. Now, whenever we call about this feedback signal or the feedback network, so eventually it identifies this entire network. This entire network, which I embed by means of a dotted line. So this is altogether the feedback network, which comprises of two different networks. One is the feed network, second one is the back network. So feed network will accept the signal SI, and accordingly it will develop a signal SO. On the other hand, the back network will accept the signal SO at its input node, and accordingly it will develop a signal SF. Now, if I assume that the negative feedback is prevalent, so in that case, this mixer circuit will develop the signal, the different signal SI, which is nothing but SS minus SF. And this SI is once again fed to this feed network, and the output signal SO will be developed over here. So whenever I designate two different networks, so I have to identify the corresponding gain pertaining to each of these networks. For example, suppose this feed network is having a gain of A and this back network is having a gain of B. So although we say B as the network gain for the back network, but eventually this B value is much, much less as compared to 1. So essentially, the signal SF is less than the signal SO. So we can say that a portion or a factor of the output signal SO will be available over here. Normally, the value of A is much, much greater than 1, whereas the value of B is less than 1. Typical value of B is less than 1. Now, from this diagram, we can easily identify the relationship between SI, SO, SF, and SS. So what is the relationship between SI and SS? SI and SS, so already we have represented SI is equal to SS plus SF or SS minus SF. So if I assume that the negative feedback is acting over here, so SI will be SS minus SF. How can I write SO? So SO is nothing but the output of the feed network. Input to the feed network is nothing but SI. So I can write SO as A times SI, as simple as that. And what about SF? SF is the output at the back network, which is nothing but B times SO. So I can write SI is equal to SS minus SF. So SF, in place of SF, I can write B times SO. Now what is SO over here? So SO is nothing but B times A times SI. So if I take SI in one side, so then you will find that SI into 1 plus AB is equal to SS. Now for the feedback network, if I consider the entire thing into our consideration, then you will find that for the feedback network, which has been identified by means of this dotted rectangle, eventually there are two defined black box. One is the feed network, second one is the back network. Now if I consider this entire feedback network as a unit, then you'll find that SS is the input to the feedback network and SO being the output of the feedback network. So if I want to find out the gain of the feedback network or gain with feedback, then the gain with feedback is represented by the factor SO upon SS, because SO is the output of the feedback network and SS is the input to the feedback network. So this is nothing but, so from this expression we have got that SI into 1 plus ABT is equal to SS. So what is SO? SO is nothing but A times SI over here upon SS. So SI upon SS is nothing but 1 by 1 plus AB. So ultimately, this expression is evaluated as A by 1 plus AB. This is known as the closed loop gain of the feedback circuit. The open loop gain is simply A. So if the back network is not present, if the back network is absent over here, so whatever be the input signal, you will find that the relationship is nothing but A times the input. The output will be equal to A times the input signal. SO equal to A times SI. Just like an amplifier, simple amplifier. Suppose I am having an amplifier with a gain of say 1000. So if I provide a 5 millivolt signal at the input of the amplifier, so it is expected that the output that is developed over here will be 5-fold. As simple as that, if there is no back network present. Now if the back network is present, then you will find that the gain has been reduced drastically. In place of A, now I have A upon A plus A beta, or A upon A plus A B. In some of the books, you'll find that this feedback factor B is represented like beta. But if I use the term beta, then it makes some confusion with the beta of the transistor. So to make sense that this feedback factor has nothing to do with the transistor current gain, so that's why I have intentionally used the term B over here. So you'll find that the gain is represented by A upon A plus AB. Now this factor, A plus AB, I think I have made some mistake over here. It will be 1 plus AB only. This is represented, if I just substitute over here, you'll find that from this expression, SI into 1 plus AB is equal to SS, so it will be A upon 1 plus AB. So this factor, 1 plus AB, is known as the desensitivity factor of the feedback network. I'm coming to that, what is meant by this desensitivity factor. Suppose you are having an amplifier. A feed forward amplifier kind of thing with a gain of say 100. So SI is the input to the amplifier, SO is the output to the amplifier. So I'm assuming that we are dealing with the midband region of the transistor operation, of the amplifier operation. So obviously the gain will be constant. So in the last unit, in unit 4, we have seen that the frequency response of the amplifier looks something like that. Initially, it will increase with the frequency, then this is the nature of the frequency response, gain versus frequency. Now I'm assuming that I am dealing within this region where gain is essentially constant and the gain value is equal to 100. You have also seen that For any single stage amplifier, common emitter amplifier, the gain is essentially controlled by the beta value of the transistor. AV, the voltage gain, is given by GM times RC. So suppose I'm assuming that the gain of the amplifier is given by 100. So I can easily write SO equal to 100 times SI, as simple as that. Now suppose by some means, there has been a change in the value of the voltage gain. So as you know, for any common emitter amplifier, the gain value is given by GM times RC. Mod of AV is given by GM times RC. And as you know, the GM, this transconductance, is heavily dependent upon the transistor parameter. So if I replace the transistor with a different one, having a different GM value, having a different beta value, then there is a high possibility that the gain may be different. Now suppose I replace the transistor with a different one, for which the gain value becomes the double. Gain value becomes the 200. Now what happens here? I have made just one change. I have just changed the transistor. I have just changed the BJT. Now by changing the BJT, I find that the relationship between SI and SO is no longer 100 times SI. Rather, it becomes 200 times SI. So I have a circuit like this. Simple circuit. We have already discussed this circuit in the last unit, last module. Just like this. Common emitter amplifier. We're taking the output from this terminal. This is the supply line, VCC. We have RC over here. This is RB, the base resistance. Coupling capacitor is over there. And we're applying the signal at this particular point. So already I've calculated in last unit that the gain resulting from this circuit is given by GM times RC. Right? Mod value, mod of AV. Now what happens? Suppose I replace this transistor with a different transistor, having a different beta. Suppose this is transistor Q1. Now I replace this transistor with a different transistor Q2, having a different beta. Then what happens for the same circuit? Circuit being the same, same VCC, same RB, same RC, same coupling capacitor, but since the transistor has been replaced by a different one, having a different beta value, having a different GM value, we'll find that the gain has been doubled. Gain has been 200 times SI as compared to 100 times SI, the output voltage, output signal. So you must appreciate that this circuit is not at all a stable one. It is having some stability issue, because if I replace the transistor with a different transistor, the gain has been changed drastically. Because that time I have told you that this particular circuit does not involve any feedback. And as soon as you make any attempt to involve feedback into the circuit, then the gain will be much more stable as compared to the fluctuation. Now suppose, instead of having only a feed network, if I have another back network over here with a feedback factor equal to, say, 0.1. So now you understand that I am having two networks, one feed network, another back network. Two networks are there. So you must identify the different parameters, A equal to 100, and B, the feedback factor is 0.1. So what is the total gain, or the gain with feedback? So gain with feedback is given by A upon 1 plus AB, as you know. So if I put the value over here, so we'll find that 10 upon 100 upon 100 into 0.1, it will be 10, 10 plus 1, 11. So 100 upon 11, so it will be like 9 point something, 9.1 or something like that. Now, suppose this particular transistor, this particular feed network is modified so that the gain becomes 200. Now, if the gain is 200, keeping this one constant, 0.1, the feedback factor, now the gain with feedback will become 200 upon 1 plus 20, because now A equal to 200, B is equal to 0.1, so 200 into 0.1 is 20, 20 plus 1, 21, so 200 by 21. So it is also close to 9.1 or 9.2, some close to that. It is even less than 10, because had this been 210, the numerator, then it will become 10. Otherwise, it is like 9.1 or something like that, or 9.115 to be precise. So what happens, even if the feed network provides a higher gain over here, but the overall gain becomes stable. Gain with feedback is stable. Gain without feedback has been doubled, 100 to 200, which is known as the feed-forward gain, or gain pertaining to the feed-forward amplifier. But as soon as we have connected this back network with the feed network, then you find that because of this factor, 1 plus AB, because of this factor is not at all sensitive to the value of A. Whatever be the value of A, the value of AF remains essentially constant. So if you have a calculator with you, then you can find out the exact value. So for 111, this value becoming like 9.09. To be precise, this value is 9.09. And this value is coming like 9.52. So it is like 9.5. So if I calculate the variation, it is only 0.4 upon 9.1. So it will be like 4%, only 4% variation, only 4% variation. Only 4% variation as compared to the 100% variation. Initially, if I don't connect this back network over here, if I don't connect the back network over here, you'll find that this feed network is having a gain 100 initially, then the gain becomes 200. So there is has been 100% change in the overall gain. However, if I connect this one, this back network in this particular fashion, for a negative feedback, you'll find that previously the gain was 9.1. And now, even if the feed forward gain has been 200, the gain with feedback is only 9.5. So if you calculate the percentage change, so percentage change is only 4%. So as compared to 100%, it is only 4%. So you must appreciate that if I connect this back network, then the circuit, the overall circuit is much more stable as compared to the any fluctuation. Now, going back to the previous slide, so if I just once again concentrate on this particular network, feedback network, so here intentionally I have used the symbol S to identify signal. So in electrical engineering, we have two different types of signals. Either we have voltage or we have current. So accordingly, the signal which I have designated by means of S, so this could have been either V or I, either voltage or current. Either you provide a voltage signal over there, voltage, or you provide a current. Similarly, the way you provide this voltage or current to the feed or to the back network, there could have been different topology pertaining to the feedback circuit. Now, before discussing further, let me tell you that these two activities, which have been performed, one over here and the other one over here, these two activities are having some name. This activity, which we perform at this end, is known as the sampling. That means we are just providing, we are just sampling the output signal over here, and we are feeding the output signal at the input of the back network. So we are sampling the output signal and we are feeding it to the back network. And over here, what we are doing, we are basically mixing the feedback signal with the actual input signal. So at this particular end, the operation which we perform is known as mixing. So with any feedback network, we have two different actions to be performed. One is known as the sampling, which is performed at the output end. And second one is known as the mixing, which is performed at the input end. Here also, depending upon the type of sampling and type of mixing, you can have two different possibilities. Either you sample current signal or you sample a voltage signal. Similarly, either you mix a current signal or you mix a voltage signal. So altogether, there could have been four different possibilities pertaining to any feedback network. So now, let me discuss those four topologies pertaining to any feedback network. So to start with, let me consider a voltage amplifier in our deliberation. So to start with, we have a voltage amplifier having a voltage gain of AV. So this is the feed network having a voltage gain of AV. And I'm just representing this one. I'm representing this one by means of a two-port network. As I've already seen, that any amplifier can be regarded as a two-port network, just like this. And similarly for the back network, it is also modeled as a two-port network, which is having a feedback factor of B. Now here, the output which is available over here is VO, and the input which we provide at this end is VS, for example. Now, if I want to sample the output voltage over here, so in that case, I need to sample the output voltage in shunt path. Because if I connect the probe of my multimeter, one at this point and other one at this point, then you can easily find out what is the voltage available at the output of this feed network. So to sample the voltage, we have to sample it in a shunt path, in a parallel path, like this. In other words, you are basically sampling the voltage signal. You are sampling the voltage signal at this end. And suppose I would like to feed the voltage signal at the input side. So if I apply a KVL over here at the input side, if I want to apply the KVL, so you must appreciate that in order to ensure that this input, so suppose here, let me identify what is the input available at over here. Suppose this input is VI, say for example. Now, if I want to ensure that this VI and VS, they are not the same. So what I need to do is, I need to break this loop. I need to break this loop and it is connected to the output of the back network, just like this. Right? So I think, let me just remove that part. So it is something like that. So the voltage that is developed over here is Vs, which we have applied over here. The signal, the voltage that is actually being fed to the input of the amplifier is AV. Now to ensure that this VI and VS, they are not the same, what we do is we connect the output of the back network in this fashion, which is known as the series fashion. And the voltage that is developed over here is VF. So now I can write, so this is VO. So now I can write VI the input to the feed network is given by Vs, the input to the feedback network, minus Vf. What is Vf over here? So Vf is nothing but V times, Vf is nothing but V times Vo. So you can easily find out that the gain, the voltage gain with feedback, is given by A by 1 plus, or AV by 1 plus AV times V. So this is the voltage gain with feedback. So here, if I want to identify the two processes, sampling and mixing, how do you sample? We are sampling the signal in shunt path. Until and unless we sample the signal in the shunt path, we cannot get the voltage over here. So the sampling is done in the shunt path, or this is also known as a voltage sampling. We are sampling the voltage, or we are sampling the output voltage over here. So this is a kind of voltage sampling. And that's why we have to sample in shunt path. And how do you mix the signal over here? We are mixing in the series path. We are mixing the signal in the series path. So it is a kind of series mixing. Series mixing. We are mixing the signal in the series path, and we are sampling the voltage signal. So in a nutshell, this entire topology is known as, so I'm just taking this voltage. So this is the nomenclature. So we take the sampling variable, this variable first, and this variable next. So throughout this entire course, I'll be using this particular nomenclature. So eventually, this one, this particular topology is known as voltage series feedback. Voltage series feedback. In some other books, you can also find this is written like shunt series kind of feedback, because we are basically sampling the signal in the shunt path. So shunt series or voltage series is having the same meaning, or voltage feedback, because you are sampling the voltage over here and you are also mixing the voltage. You are sampling the voltage over here and you are also mixing the voltage. So voltage feedback. So in my discussion, I will refer this type of network as a voltage series kind of feedback. So whenever I refer the signal, the feedback as a voltage series feedback, then you must understand that we are sampling the voltage. So first sampling comes, then mixing. So you're sampling the voltage. And how do you mix the signal? We mix the signal in series path. So voltage series. Now, if I want to find out the input impedance of this kind of network, then obviously you have to embed this entire thing within a black box. Because whenever I consider the feedback network, so feedback network means the thing that we embed within this dotted rectangle. This is the entire feedback network, consisting of a feed network and a back network. One of the advantages of feedback, I have already mentioned, the advantage lies in increasing the stability of the overall circuit, overall network. And the second advantage of the feedback network is the modification of the input and the output impedance. So you can also modify, either you increase the input impedance or you decrease input impedance depending upon the way you perform this sampling and mixing operation. So the circuit inside this black box is the feedback network. So if I want to find out the input impedance, so I have to identify what is the signal, what is the voltage signal available between these two ports, and what is the current that is entering to the feedback network. So if I assume that the current that is entering over here, if I assume that the current that is entering over here is Is, And if the voltage available over here is Vs, then you must appreciate that the input resistance with feedback is given by Vs upon Is. Vs upon Is. So this is the input resistance of the network with feedback. Now, I have to identify the relationship between Vs and Vi. Eventually, for the network AV, for the feed network, already this is an amplifier circuit. So obviously, it is having some input impedance, and that impedance is suppose Ri. So what is the relationship between Vi and Ri? So Vi, which is the actual input provided to the feed network, is given by Ri times the current that is flowing through it. Now you have to identify whether this current, if I write this current like II current, II. Now you have to identify whether this current, this II, and this current, IS, whether these two currents are same or not. Since we don't have any additional path through which a portion of the current can be taken back, so this current IS that is entering through this terminal is eventually the current that is also entering the feed network, because there is no other escape route, there is no other path through which you can basically take away this current. There is no other path. The current that is entering over here, it will flow through this path. So IS and II, these two currents being the same. So Vi is equal to Ri into II, fine. Now R in F, we have already written this one, like Vs upon Is. So what is Vs? So Vs is nothing but Vs is nothing but Vi plus Vf. Already we have written this one. Vi is equal to Vs minus Vf. So Vs is equal to Vi plus Vf. What is the feedback voltage? This feedback voltage is nothing but B times the output voltage Vo. And what is Vo? Vo is nothing but A times Vi. So I can write Vs as 1 plus AB times Vi. So if I put this one, this expression, so I will find that Vs is given by Vi into 1 plus AB upon Is or II. Now what is this Vi by II called? This is nothing but the input resistance of the feed network. So this is Ri. So Ri multiplied with 1 plus AB. So the input resistance with feedback is given by the input resistance of the feed network multiplied with the desensitivity factor. So let me summarize once again. I am having a feed network over here, a voltage amplifier having a voltage gain of AV, and a back network having a feedback factor of B. Now this is a kind of voltage series kind of feedback, because we are sampling the voltage. That means the output voltage is being fed to the back network. You can also feed the output current, but here we have fed the output voltage. So that's why a shunt kind of sampling. And the back network will produce a feedback voltage, which is added in series path. And as a matter of fact, the input to the amplifier is given by Vs minus Vf. So what is that Vf? Vf is nothing but the feedback voltage. So this is a kind of negative feedback. So there is a negative sign over here, Vs minus Vf. Now accordingly, I can find out the input impedance. I can find out the input impedance of this network, feed network only, which has been represented by Ri. So this Ri will relate the Vi, the voltage developed over here, with the current that is entering. So Vi equal to Ri into II, and the input resistance with feedback has to be calculated looking at this particular terminal. Now here, the available voltage is Vs and the current that is entering is Is. So as a matter of fact, the input resistance with feedback, considering the feed network and back network together, is given by Vs upon Is. So with some calculation, you'll find that this Rin F is coming like Ri into 1 plus Av. So you'll see that whenever we make a series kind of mixing, then the input impedance will be increased. And whenever we have a shunt kind of mixing, then the input impedance will be reduced. So this particular topology is for the voltage series feedback network. Now let me go to the next type of feedback network, which involves a current shunt kind of feedback. So to start with, let me just draw the two black box first. So these are nothing but the generic diagrams. So in the next few classes, I'll be discussing about the implementation of those different feedback topologies using BJT and the associated elements. First of all, you have to identify the generic architecture, which one is voltage series, which one is current series, which one is voltage shunt, which one is current shunt, and so on. So already we have discussed about the voltage series in the last slide. Now here, let me consider the topology of a different type of feedback. Let me call this feedback as a current shunt kind of feedback. So we have a feed network over here, A. We have a back network over here, that is B. So I'm just representing this two networks by means of a two-port networks, both the feed and the back network. Now, instead of sampling the voltage, so last time we have sampled the voltage, so that's why the sampling was performed in the shunt path. Now, if I want to sample the current, suppose there is a network, there is a line, there is a wire, I would like to find out the current that is flowing through this particular wire. So what has to be done? I have to break the loop and I have to insert one ammeter. Similarly, here also, if I want to sample the current over here, or in other words, if I want to feed the output current of the feed network at the input of the back network, then I have to break the loops. Initially, the loop was there. Now I need to break the loop and I need to sample the current and I need to feed this one. I need to feed this one at the input of the back network. It looks something like that. So the current that was flowing, this current was like IO. The same current will flow through this. I have just broken the loop. And the same current will flow through the back network. And the corresponding current will be developed over here, which I designate by IF, for example. So since the current is sampled at this particular end and output side, so this is known as a current sampling. So we are sampling the current, and this sampling is performed in series path. So this is known as a current sampling. How do I want to mix the signal at the input side? I would like to mix the signal in the shunt path. So shunt path is the parallel path. So how do I connect? I have connected like this. So what happens? The current that is entering at this particular point. Suppose this current is IS, and the current that is actually entering the amplifier over here is II. And I need to ensure that this current II is less as compared to IS. So then I have to take a portion of the current. I need to take a portion of the current out of this IS, and this current is nothing but the current IS. So now I can write the relationship II is equal to IS minus IS. So considering the discussion in slide number one, let me go back once again. So we have once again considered the same kind of thing, that SI is given by SS minus SF. So whether you sample the signal as a voltage or you sample the signal as current, so that makes the change. Whether you mix the signal as a voltage or you mix the signal as current, that makes the change. So here, SI was represented by SS minus SF for a negative feedback. And the signal for this topology is the current signal. So that's why it is represented by II is equal to IS minus IF. So what is the relationship between IO and IF? So IO and IF, they are represented by this one, this particular function. IF is equal to B times IO, because IO is fed to the input of the back network, and back network will produce a portion of the output current. So that's why IF is represented by beta times IO. And this IF is mixed at the input side. And II is represented by IS minus IF. So if you just calculate the corresponding gain, so as you understand, this particular feed network is nothing but a current amplifier, AI. So you can easily identify the relationship between II and IO. So this IO is represented by AI times II. And II is equal to IS minus IF, and IF is equal to beta times IO. So following the same analogy, if you calculate this ratio IO upon IS, so this is coming like IO upon IS is coming like AI upon 1 plus AI times B. Remember that this entire thing, 1 plus AB, this entire thing is a unitless quantity. So last time also, we have seen that it was like 1 plus AV into B. Now, for a voltage amplifier, this AV is generally unitless. Say 100, 200, 500, just like this. It is generally unitless. Similarly, for the current amplifier, for this one, this AI, this is also unitless, the current gain, say 100, 150, 200, like this. So as a matter of fact, both for this voltage series feedback and also for this current shunt kind of feedback, this feedback factor is unitless, only a factor. Now, I have already mentioned this one verbally, so let me write it down. How do you sample? You sample current. How do you mix? You mix in the shunt path. So it's a shunt mixing. You are mixing in the shunt path or parallel path. If you mix in the shunt path, then only you can mix current. And if you mix in the series path, then only you can mix the voltage. If I want to sample the voltage, then I have to sample in shunt path, in parallel path. And if I want to sample the current, I have to sample in the series path. So following the same analogy, I'm just taking this current and this shunt together. And this topology is known as current shunt topology. It's a current shunt topology. The gain with feedback, AIF, is represented by IO upon IS, which is equal to AI upon 1 plus AI into B. So once again, for this network also, if I would like to find out the corresponding input impedance, so I have to first of all, I need to encircle this entire thing, embed this entire thing within a dotted rectangle. So this is the entire feedback network, which I am just embedding by means of a dotted rectangle. So this is the entire network. Now it comprises of two different networks, two different models. One is AI, this one, second one is B. Now already for this current amplifier, we have some resistance RI, which is nothing but VI upon II. Now suppose the signal, as far as our notation is concerned, the signal, the voltage that is available over here is Vs. Now, if you just look at this input side of this feedback network, you'll find that this Vs and this VI, essentially these two terms are the same, Vs and VI, because there is a direct connection between from this point to this point and this point to this point. So there is a direct connection. So Vs and VI being the same. However, Is and II not the same. So I can write this expression like this. So R in F. So here, R in F, I can write Vs upon Is. The same formula, Vs upon Is, R in F. Vs is the signal developed over here or applied over here, and Is is the current being drawn by the feedback network. So if I would like to find out the resistance with feedback, then you'll see that this is nothing but Vs upon Is. Now, this Vs upon Is can be represented by Vi upon Is, because Vi and Vs being the same. And if you calculate the relationship between Is and II, then you'll see that II was represented like Is minus IF. So I can write Is is equal to II plus IF. So what is IF? IF is beta times IO, B times IO, and IO is AI times II. So it is nothing but AI times B times II. So eventually, this IS becomes II into 1 plus AI into B. So I can write VI directly over here, and the denominator, what I can write II into 1 plus AIB. Now, VI by II, this is nothing but the input resistance without feedback. So, RI upon 1 plus AIB. So, here, the input resistance with feedback is reduced by this desensitivity factor. This is quite obvious because whenever you connect something in shunt, initially when this back network was absent, so the resistance was RI, fine. Now, when you connect this back network in shunt with this feed network, that means this back network is loading this feed network or feed amplifier, feed forward amplifier. So obviously, when you connect some load in shunt with another load, so the effective resistance will be dropped down. So same thing happens over here. So resistance with feedback for a shunt kind of mixing is given by RI upon 1 plus AI into B. So R in F is given by RI upon 1 plus AI into B. So let me summarize once again. This particular topology is for a current shunt type of feedback. So whenever we say current shunt type of feedback, so the signal that is sampled at the output side is the current signal. So how to sample the current signal? In order to sample a current signal, I need to break the loop. Otherwise, I can't measure what is the current that is flowing at the output side of this feed network, and accordingly I feed this current, this output current, to the input of the back network. This back network will develop a feedback current which is given by IF, and this current IF, when added with II, will give you the total current IS. So in other words, the current IS, the externally provided current IS, and the current that is actually entering the amplifier, they are not the same. A portion of IS will be taken away by this back network, which is in the form of IF. So we can write II equal to IS minus IF. And following some mathematical calculation, you'll find that the gain with feedback is given by AI upon 1 plus AIB. And this 1 plus AIB is the desensitivity factor. And the input impedance with feedback is given by input impedance without feedback divided by 1 plus AIB. So already we have discussed the two topologies pertaining to this feedback amplifier, the generic topologies also. Now, let me consider the third one, the third topology. So already we have discussed about the voltage series and current shunt. Now, two other topologies are still left. So there is one feed network, one back network as usual. Now, suppose I would like to sample the voltage. I'd like to sample the voltage from the output of the amplifier. So if I would like to sample the voltage, how can I perform that one? To sample the voltage, you have to connect in the shunt path, just like this, so that you can essentially identify what is the voltage available at the output of the feed network. Suppose this voltage is VO, which is available over here. You are basically taking that voltage or feeding that voltage to the input of the back network. And eventually, back network will develop some signal, not in the form of voltage, rather in the form of current. So for voltage series, we have seen that we have, for voltage series kind of feedback, we have seen that in the first demonstration, the voltage is sampled and the voltage is mixed at the input side. Voltage is sampled at the output side and the voltage is mixed at the input side. Now here, we sample the voltage, but we mix the current. Now to mix the current, if I want to mix the current, so current mixing is possible whenever you mix it a parallel path. Current mixing is possible whenever you mix the current in the parallel path. And voltage mixing is possible whenever you mix the voltage in the parallel path, series path. So now, if I make this arrangement, then you'll see that this one is VS, this one is VI, eventually both of them being the same. This is IF, this current was IS, this current is II, this current is IO. So how do I sample? I sample the voltage. So it's a kind of voltage sampling. Voltage sampling. I sample the voltage. And how do I mix? I mix the current. Because there is no change as far as the magnitude of VS and VI are concerned, because they are connected directly. So VS and VI being the same. Rather, IS and II, they are not the same. So that's why this is a kind of current mixing. But how do you mix the current? You mix the current in the shunt path. So It's a shunt type of mixing. Shunt mixing. So taking together, this is an example of voltage shunt. This is an example of voltage shunt feedback amplifier. Now, what about this particular feed network? You find that we are treating the input signal as the current signal, because this is the relation over here. II is equal to IS minus IF. We are treating the input signal as a current signal and the output signal as a voltage signal. So the gain of the amplifier is having an unit of resistance. So I can write this like Rm, because the input signal is current here, the output signal is voltage here, V naught, that we essentially sample. So it's a trans resistance type of amplifier. So the unit of this amplifier gain is the unit of a resistance. And regarding the desensitivity factor, once again, you'll find that the RMF with feedback, the gain becomes like RM upon 1 plus RM into B. Since the desensitivity factor is unitless, this entire thing is unitless, so B is having the unit of a conductance. So this particular circuit is for voltage shunt. And following the same analogy, if I would like to find out the input resistance, R in F, with feedback, you will find that this R in F is given by R in upon 1 plus Rm into B, which is nothing but the desensitivity factor. So let me summarize for this one, for this particular feedback topology. Here, we have got a voltage shunt kind of feedback. So since it's a voltage feedback, so I have to take the signal, I have to take the output signal in shunt path, otherwise I can't sample the voltage. So shunt sampling or voltage sampling over here, that is fine. This has been fed to the input of the back network. The back network will develop a proportionate current waveform, IF, and which when added with II will give you the total current IS. So in other words, II is given by IS minus IF. So for the back network, the input is the voltage and the output is the current. So this is having a unit of conductance over here. Since we mix the signal in the shunt path, so it's a kind of current mixing. So for this particular network, feed network, the input is the current as we regard, and the output is the voltage. So it's a kind of voltage shunt feedback. And the unit of the gain is nothing but the unit of a resistance, because I can write VO, this output voltage. VO is represented by II times the gain of the amplifier, which is nothing but Rin. So already we have discussed three different topologies. Only one is left. That is, so we have discussed about the voltage series, we have discussed about the current shunt, and finally we have discussed about the voltage shunt. So only one topology is left, that is current series. So for current series, as the name suggests, you have to sample the current signal. You need to sample the current signal. So how do you sample the current? You need to break the loop. You need to break the loop. This is the B network. The same output current is flowing through the back network. That is good. And you are feeding the signal in the series path. So since you feed the signal in the series path, so that mixing must be in a series path. So here the signal that is developed over here is Vs, and this signal is Vi. And over here, so this side positive, this side negative, it's minus, and over here, Vf is developed at the output of the back network. So I can write Vi is equal to Vs minus Vf. And Vf is given by B times Io. So Io is the output current that you feed at the input of the back network. Now for this network, feed network, the input is a voltage, the output is a current. So I can write, I can regard the gain is having unit of conductance, and the gain with feedback can be represented by Gm upon 1 plus Gm into B. Now this 1 plus Gm into B is nothing but the desensitivity factor, and since Gm is having an unit of conductance, so B must be having an unit of resistance. Now considering the input resistance, this input resistance with feedback can be written like this, R in or Ri multiplied with 1 plus Gm beta, 1 plus Gm B. Because here the mixing occurs in the series path. So whenever you have a mixing in the series path, so there will be change in the, there will be increase in the input resistance. So here we sample the current. So it's a current sampling. You sample the current. So it's a current sampling at the output side. And you mix the voltage, voltage mixing, or the mixing takes place in the series path or series mixing. So altogether, this is an example of current series kind of feedback. Current series kind of feedback. Now let me summarize the four different topologies. Whenever you sample sampling and mixing, so let me just consider these two together. It will be better to move in this direction. Sampling and second one is mixing. So altogether there could have been four possibilities. There could have been four possibilities. So you can sample voltage. You can sample voltage. Or you can sample current. Similarly, you can mix voltage. You can mix the voltage. Or you can mix the current. Now, depending upon the signal that you sample or that you mix, there could have been four different possibilities. So as you understand, voltage kind of thing, current voltage kind of thing, current voltage kind of thing, or current kind of thing. But whenever you make any attempt to sample the voltage signal, so sampling of any voltage signal must be done in the shunt path. Sampling of any voltage signal must be done in the shunt path. And sampling of the current signal must be done in the series path. Similarly, while you mix the signal, if you want to mix the voltage signal, this mixing must be in the series path. And if you want to mix the current signal, that must be in the shunt path. So if you just take a look at this particular matrix, you'll see that with voltage, the shunt term will be there when you sample the voltage. But if you want to mix the voltage, so that mixing must be in a series. Similarly, for the current signal, if you want to sample the current, then you have to sample it in the series path. But if you want to mix the current signal at the input side of the feed network, then that mixing must be done in the shunt path. So accordingly, we have four different possibilities. And this is our nomenclature to use the sampling first, followed by mixing. So throughout the discussion, we will be following this particular nomenclature. First sampling, followed by mixing. During sampling, we will only mention the variable, and during mixing, we will mention the way we mix the signal. So that's why within this box, I should write, this is a kind of voltage series feedback, voltage sampling and series mixing. Here, I will write current series. Here I must write voltage shunt. And here it will be current shunt. Now, it could have different names in different other books. In some book, you will find that instead of mentioning like voltage series, they can also refer like shunt series, because voltage and shunt, when voltage is sampled, so this is sampled in the shunt path. So instead of mentioning this feedback as a voltage series kind of feedback, one can also refer this particular type of topology as a shunt series kind of feedback. Or in some other literature, you can also find this one as voltage feedback, or shunt series kind of feedback. So all four possibilities are possible. So as long as you maintain this one, the sampling mixing kind of topology, first sampling followed by mixing, then voltage series or shunt series or voltage or shunt voltage. So all these topologies or all these nomenclatures are perfect. Similarly, for this current series kind of feedback, one can also refer this as current voltage kind of feedback. Current voltage or series kind of feedback. For this one, sampling occurs in the shunt path. So one can also refer this as shunt kind of feedback, because sampling occurs in the shunt path and mixing occurs in the shunt path. So that's why shunt kind of feedback, or you can also say like voltage shunt kind of feedback. And finally, this one, you can also refer, instead of saying like current shunt kind of feedback, you can also refer this type of feedback as series shunt kind of feedback, or current type of feedback. So as long as you maintain this one, the sampling followed by mixing, this particular topology, so this voltage series and shunt series, they bear the same significance. So today I have discussed the basic notion of the feedback amplifier. What is the use of feedback amplifier to increase the stability of any network? If a network doesn't have any back network, implicitly within the structure, then obviously you have seen that the circuit is not at all stable. If I change the transistor, if I replace the transistor with a different one, then you'll see that the corresponding change occurs significantly in the overall gain, as identified in this particular slide. Now, if I incorporate the notion of back network within the circuit itself, then the circuit becomes much more stable. But there is one problem associated with feedback network. The problem lies in the fact that if I do not use a feedback, then obviously the gain is typically large. As you understand, the gain is only A. But once we connect the back network along with the feed network, then the gain is dropped by A by 1 plus AB. So instead of having a gain of 100, now I am having a gain of 9 or gain close to 10. So gain has dropped down significantly. So this is one of the disadvantages associated with feedback. So it reduces the gain significantly. So if I want to achieve a gain of 100, so without feedback, only one amplifier stage is good enough to achieve a gain of 100. But if I incorporate a feedback network in our application, then the gain of 100 has been reduced to gain of 10 only, 9.1, that is close to 10. So to achieve a gain of 100, I need to have at least two stages of amplification. So hardware cost is more over here if I want to achieve the same gain, because the gain has been dropped significantly for feedback amplifier. But the biggest advantage associated with the feedback amplifier is that it is much more stable as compared to the normal feed-forward amplifier, in which case there is no feedback network. And depending upon the sampling mixing kind of topology, we can have four different types of feedback circuit, depending upon the signal that you sample and the signal or the way you mix the signal at the input side. You can have voltage series kind of feedback, you can have current shunt kind of feedback, you can have voltage shunt kind of feedback, and finally the current series kind of feedback. Now today I have just represented or demonstrated those different types of the feedback by means of only block diagram. So it's a block diagram kind of representation, a generic representation to identify what type of feedback it is actually. And in the next class, I'll be discussing about the circuit realization using the bipolar junction transistor. And then you can really appreciate whether whether any particular circuit provides any feedback or not. And if yes, then what type of feedback it is, whether it's a current series kind of feedback or voltage shunt kind of feedback or current shunt kind of feedback or voltage series kind of feedback, just by looking at the, or just by drawing the small signal diagram, small signal equivalent circuit of those amplifiers, you can easily identify whether the feedback is there or not, and if yes, then what type of feedback. Now with this, I would like to conclude today's class.